A furious alchemy it is, these words. Though often logical enough, the consequences remain clear. I'm not speaking of cryptic parchments or barely discernible manuscripts, but of language itself. It simultaneously liberates and betrays, preserves and destroys, heals and infects, all the while placing us all in harm's way, in constant danger of misunderstanding. That which we adore is so incredibly fragile. As we cling to some sense of cosmic order, only for a brief moment are we ever stable, then fall back to our fractured nature. Is there any such thing as rest in our universe? I will not fall prey to the spirit of the age. I will dive deep into the oldest waters, where the light is so ancient that it taught songs to the gods. This shroud does not become you. Your well is of despair. Despite my thirst, I will not drink here. Your dying star is wearisome. A hallucinatory psychology suspends doubt and common rules. Walk with the apparition across the threshold. Chant the wordless songs. Breathe in the storm. Its pattern is well known to you. Spit out the venom. It is what you meant to say anyway. A remarkable fragment of yourself descends upon the Song of Songs. Ignoring the watchful eye of our star, the frost burns its way across the earth's breast. Beware the messenger half buried in stone. Shield ourselves with skin, that our spirits do not drain or lie trapped beneath our souls, which are not prepared for the mother. All shall hear her words in the end. Entranced and transfixed in our own transformation, reshaping our realities into natural phenomena. This is not our first winter. Damnation awaits these hours with silent waves. We are only visitors here, borrowing wasted time. cultivating an age of the grotesque. We circumnavigate the falls as lightning strikes the wonder and transcends watched omens with the fierce radiance of a proud horse. Iron and rust run through the coals to quench in oil, with a consuming hunger to rise when fires flare, inhabiting the imminent need of nature itself.